Welcome back to Grade 8 History, Unit Number 2, Canada's Changing Society, 1890 to 1914. This is Lesson Number 19. Why were people moving to Canada? Before we begin today's video, let's consider the following. Why do you think immigrants would want to come to Canada in the late 1800s and early 1900s? When I'm finished speaking, you're going to put the video on pause so that you can consider this question a little further and then write down your response. Please put the video on pause now. And let's begin. When studying immigration, historians look at pull factors, things that attract settlers to a particular country. Historians also study push factors, things that make people want to leave their home countries. And we actually did this in geography. We found that pull factors include freedom, economic opportunity, abundant land. Push factors would be population growth or overpopulation, agricultural changes, crop failures. Historically, the Industrial Revolution actually made some people feel that they were being pushed out of their home countries, as well as religious and political turmoil. So yes, in geography, we do study present day push and pull factors, but historians do the same thing. They just look at things that were going on in the past. From 1896 to 1914, Canada experienced a huge wave of immigration. Over this period, Canada's population increased by 3 million people. This incredibly fast rise in the population was due to several important push and pull factors. In the 1890s, more food, such as wheat, was needed to feed the growing population of Canada. Also, Canadian wheat was in high demand by other countries due to its high quality. The Prairie provinces were seen as the perfect place to plant new wheat crops. In 1872, the government started offering free farmland to settlers in the Northwest. The Canadian Pacific Railway also promoted immigration to help build the railway and settle the land around it. The Canadian government used immigration posters to attract people from other countries to come to Canada. Take a look at this poster here. How is the government presenting Canada to immigrants? When I finish speaking, please put the video on pause so that you can get a closer look at this poster and then write down your thoughts on how the government was presenting Canada to immigrants. And let's move on. Many people credit Sir Clifford Sifton with driving the immigration boom. Sifton was Laurier's Minister of the Interior. This position made him responsible for managing land, immigration, and First Nations affairs. Sifton created an ambitious plan to attract newcomers to Canada. He began by bringing experienced farmers from Eastern and Central Europe to rural areas in the Prairie provinces. In these areas, the immigrant farmers would build homesteads or farms. Sifton felt that Eastern and Central European farmers were strong and would know how to farm in the harsher climate and in conditions on the prairies. Sifton used a variety of tactics to entice immigrants to come to Canada. His strategies included building Canadian exhibits at fairs, posting ads in European newspapers, and encouraging settlers to invite friends and family members to come join them in Canada. He also distributed pamphlets overseas, which included testimonials from immigrants who spoke about their success in Canada. Sifton also hired agents to travel across Europe and give speeches about the great opportunities that Canada offered. These strategies worked, and the prairie population grew rapidly. By offering free land to immigrants, Canada attracted immigrants from a wide variety of countries. During the immigration boom, people from Britain, America, the Ukraine, Romania, Germany, Poland, Italy, and China came to Canada. Political and social tensions were also rising in parts of Europe. Many people who faced violence and discrimination because of their religion or their culture felt that they could find a safer and better life in Canada. The Canadian government promised immigrants that they would be free to practice their own religion in their new country. The Doukhobors were one example of a group that came to Canada to escape persecution. The Doukhobors were Russian pacifists, people who are opposed to war and violence. In Russia, Doukhobor men who refused to serve the mandatory military service faced beatings, imprisonment, and exile. Their families would also receive cruel mistreatment. In 1899, more than 7,500 Doukhobors arrived in Canada. And this painting shows the Doukhobors burning their weapons in protest against the Russian government. My question for you is, what mood has the artist created in this painting? When I'm finished speaking, please put the video on pause so you can write down your thoughts on what mood the artist has created in this painting. And moving forward. In Europe, there was a growing feeling of anti-Semitism, or prejudice against Jewish people. Jewish people were being blamed for the problems of European society, and they were the targets of anti-Jewish laws, such as the Russian pogroms, which forced Jewish people from their homes and neighborhoods. Some of the Jewish immigrants who sought safety in Canada settled on the prairies. However, most Jewish immigrants settled into the existing Jewish communities in Montreal, Toronto, and Winnipeg. Many women moved to Canada in search of work. From 1900 to 1911, more than 90,000 women from Britain and more than 25,000 women from other parts of Europe immigrated to Canada to find work as domestic servants. Take a look at this pamphlet. According to this pamphlet, what were the benefits of moving to Canada? Here's a hint. Take a look at the top left. How does this advertisement differ from how Canada was being promoted in the posters we saw earlier in this lesson? So when I finish speaking, please put the video on pause so you can write down your responses to these two questions. All right, and moving onwards. The journey from Europe to Canada was very long. The trip often required taking multiple boats, trains, and wagons over a period of weeks or even months. While they were full of hope when they began the journey, a number of immigrants will later speak about how they doubted their decision to move to Canada as the journey came to an end. In time, however, these brave newcomers and their children will come to enjoy the benefits of taking a risk for the chance of a new and better life in Canada. Just take a look at this picture here. How prepared do you think the people in this photo are or were prepared for life in Canada? When I finish speaking, please put the video on pause so that you can write down your response to this question. Okay, time for the wrap up. So let's finish today's video by considering the following, and then we'll talk about these two questions next day. One. Why did Sifton believe it was necessary to Canada's success as a country to bring new immigrant groups to Canada? And two, how do you think Sifton should be remembered by Canadians today? When I finish speaking, you'll put the video on pause so you can write down your responses to these two questions. If you don't feel prepared to answer one or both of these two questions, it means you need to go back and watch this video at least one more time. And then when you're feeling confident, please put the video on pause. All right, I look forward to hearing your responses to these and the other questions posted throughout this recording. But until tomorrow's class, this concludes today's video.